How is your morale here?
It's good.
Is it high enough? Is the rain bothering you? Well, if the bombs that are raining down on the Gazan people right now is not breaking their will, the rain dropping on us here is not going to deter us. My brothers and sisters, in 1917, Britain and the Zionist movement thought that they would be able to erase Palestine from the global collective memory. But here we are, 107 years after, Palestine is still standing. In 1948, Israel tried to once again erase Palestine and to uproot the Palestinian people. But again, here we are, 76 years after, Palestine is still standing. In 1967, Israel tried once again to erase Palestine, but this time once and for all, and to quash the Palestinian people. But here we are, 57 years after, Palestine is still standing. The Palestinian people have never vanished. For over 107 years, genocide, war crimes, ethnic cleansing, displacement, massive starvation, rape have been deployed by Israel and by the Zionist movement against the Palestinian people. But the Palestinian people have never been vanished. Their resilience was never broken and it would never break. Let us fast forward now to 2023. For the past 225 days, but remember this as part or to be within the context of the 107 years. Keep that 107 years alive. Keep that 107 years context present. But now we're talking about the past 225 days since Israel launched this brutal attack on Gaza. Israel resorted again to the tactics that it had never abandoned. Another collective genocide, war crimes, crimes against humanity, massacres, rape.
Shame.
But still, Gaza stands tall. And the Palestinian people are still holding their heads up and high. Israel has tried this before, with the support of Britain, with the support of the US, but they have failed and failed utterly, and they will continue to fail. Let us go back to the 107 years ago. Let us go back to the 1917. Under the Wilson administration, or since the Wilson administration in 1917, consecutive American administrations have been complicit, completely in support of Israel, because the Balfour Declaration wasn't issued prior to the approval of the Wilson administration. And since then we have been complicit. And Biden is no different. The only difference that he injected into the equation is that he took us to another war. That's the only thing that Biden is distinguished by. He's justifying protecting, aiding, and acting a genocide that is taking place before the world's eyes. And yet they have the audacity to claim that genocide is not occurring in Gaza. The corrupt, stupid, dumb John Kirby said, "We see no signs of genocide in Gaza." Genocide Joe says, "We see no signs of genocide being committed in Gaza." Antony Blinken doesn't see genocide taking place in Gaza. Jack Sullivan doesn't see genocide taking place in Gaza. Now we're funding this war machine. We're funding this genocide with tens of billions of dollars. We just, this corrupt institution that is being hijacked from the American people. This Congress does not speak for us. This Congress does not represent the will of the people. This Congress that had just approved, appropriated $26 billion for Israel. Now we're claiming favors. We're doing the Palestinian people a favor. We're building a pier. We're going to get humanitarian aid. 90 truckloads a day to a 2.2 starving million people. A few hundred millions of dollars, as opposed to over $250 billion in terms of investment of American money, taxpaying money, in this colonial, in this genocide regime in Israel for the past 76 years. Yeah. And now we're doing the Palestinian people a favor. We're funding the bombs. We're paying for the F-16s, the F-15s, the F-35s. Yeah. We're paying for the heavy bombs, and we're paying for the missiles and all of the artillery. And we're paying to continue to protect Israel on the world stage. And then we're doing the Palestinian people a favor. We're sending you some food. We're giving you tens of millions of dollars worth of humanitarian aid. But you know what? While you get that box of food, we're gonna drop a bomb on you. While you get that barrel of water, we're gonna drop another bomb on you. When Biden is shedding this crocodile tears over the suffering of the Palestinian children, he is paying and equipping Israel with the missiles that are killing them in their beds, in their own bedrooms. While Blinken is talking about the pain and how he identifies with the pain with Palestinian parents who lose their children because he remembers that he's a father. He remembers that he's a father. He's still funding Israel and clearing the way for more of billions of dollars. And now, above all, to add an insult to an injury, Biden thinks that the American people are stupid like him, that they can be fooled like him, and he is bragging about holding one shipment of weapons to Israel while he continues to give Israel more shipments, hundreds of shipments, and worth tens of billions of dollars. And he thinks that we're not seeing this. We're blind like him, that we're morally corrupt like him. Let me tell you who represents America. It is not Genocide Joe. It is not this corrupt institution that has been hijacked. It is not the bankrupt, morally bankrupt politicians. It is not the corrupt media. It is us. It is us who represent the conscience of America. It is the students, the college students, who represent the conscience of America. It is the majority of America, the American people, who demand a ceasefire, an immediate permanent ceasefire, an end to this aggression. They know that the past may have belonged to them. They know that the future belongs to us. That's why they're trying to intimidate us. That's why they're trying to defame us. That's why they're trying to silence us. That's why they're trying to criminalize us. That's why they're trying to weaponize the American government, the college administrations, against the freedom of expression, against the freedom of assembly, against our constitutional rights. But as Johnson failed in the 1960s, as Nixon failed in the 1970s, as Reagan failed in the 1980s, America will prevail and the conscience will prevail, and Palestine will be free and will prevail.